With war in the Middle East and all the chaos in the world, people will call out for a global government and leader to restore order and peace. The man who becomes world leader will promise peace by forming a one world religion, but he and his prophet will instead start an all-out nuclear war. The Bible reports that a quarter of the world's population, almost 2 billion people, will die from this war. He will subdue his enemies and make a peace treaty with Israel. When that treaty is signed, you'll know the tribulation will last 7 more years. It makes me so sad to say that the world war will result in terrible famine, disease, and mass death. Violence, sickness, and starvation will be your way of life over the 7 years. The Bible also warns, and you'll see, devastating earthquakes, meteor impacts, solar flares, and poison oceans. Those will destroy most of what's left of the earth. I have to warn you about this world leader, whom the Bible calls Antichrist. Halfway into the tribulation, he will declare himself to be God in the newly built Jewish temple and demand everybody worship him. To prove your loyalty, the world leader will ask you to have his name marked on your forehead or right hand. In reality, by choosing loyalty to him, you choose loyalty to his master, Satan. By refusing his mark, he'll punish you by cutting off your ability to buy anything and even sentence you to death. But the Bible promises that everybody who takes the leader's mark will lose any chance of Jesus rescuing them. Without Jesus, a person is condemned to God's ultimate justice, hell. Taking his mark is a terrible forever decision and not the choice you want to make. But throughout this awful time, God will give the world a message of hope, from 2 men in Jerusalem to 144,000 believing Jewish people to even an angel from God. They will proclaim Jesus and his salvation across the entire planet. Millions will call out to Jesus to save them, and I pray you'll be one of them. With all these people accepting Jesus' love and deliverance, you would not be alone. So how will it all end? With the battle to end all battles, in an Israeli valley called Armageddon, the conflict will ignite when the Antichrist army fights a rebellion from the Far East. But now is when that happy ending I've mentioned finally happens. As Jesus returns to earth and enters into the battle himself, you've probably seen images of a weak Jesus dying on a cross. Well, not this time. He's coming back as a powerful king with his own army. And those loved ones taken in the rapture, they're coming back with him as well. It'll be no competition. Jesus will defeat the armies at Armageddon. Jesus will then send us the world leader and his prophet to hell and banish Satan into a deep pit. Jesus will be victorious, and all who continue to rebel against him are justly going to be put to death, every last one of them. Only those who have accepted Jesus as Savior will continue to live on from this point. After Jesus' victory, he'll turn the world into a garden paradise, totally erasing the ravages of war and disasters. He'll set up his kingdom on earth just like in heaven, and he'll rule justly with his love from his throne in Jerusalem over those who throughout history have put their trust in him.
If you've lost a loved one in the rapture, you're wondering, will I ever see them again? Well, the short answer to that one is, it all depends on the decision that you must make. Whether you die in this tribulation or not, you must allow God to save your soul. Everybody who turns down Jesus' lifeline of salvation is going to hell. It's the punishment for continued rebellion against God. And hell, it's an awful prison of burning and loneliness. To choose hell is not to see your loved ones, or anybody else for that matter, ever again. But if you believe in Jesus and accept his loving sacrifice, then yes, you'll definitely be reunited with your loved ones.
Just because you were left behind doesn't mean that God's abandoned you. God has made you a promise, and you can find it in the Bible in John chapter 3, verse 16. It goes, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life." Believe in God's Son, Jesus. Grab hold of his promise and pray right now, "Dear Jesus, forgive me of my sins and be my Savior." Jesus, in turn, will make you a brand new person inside. His Spirit will be your guide in these dark days, and when you die, he'll deliver you to be with him forever. Now, you don't have much time left on this earth, so quickly, go get a Bible and begin reading the part called The Gospel According to John. If you want to learn more about what to expect during the tribulation, go to the end, the book called Revelation, or go on the web at lamblion.com and raptureready.com. And join with others who have also accepted Jesus as Savior, so that you can grow in your knowledge of God and to help each other survive. God does not want you to go it alone. If you've accepted Jesus, we'll be waiting for you at home in heaven.